I want to demonstrate the new checksum capabilities. And so I'm going to upload two new objects to my bucket, specifically two new photos of my dog, Sky. And I'm going to do that using the new checksum capabilities. And I'm going to verify that my objects were uploaded using checksums. OK, so to do that, I'm going to click on upload. I'm going to drag in a photo. And I'm going to scroll down to properties for that object. And I can see that I've got a new option here, additional checksums. And me, being the durability-obsessed engineer that I am, I have a catalog of checksums that I keep for my dog photos. And so I'm going to copy in a checksum that S3 will use to verify to make sure that the object data isn't changed during that upload. OK. So I'm going to copy in actually the wrong value here first to see what happens if I give a checksum that won't match. And when I click on upload, you can see that very quickly it's telling me the pre-calculated value that I provided for this object doesn't match the data that it was calculated on the S3 server. Great. So now I'll copy in the correct checksum. Paste that in here, and I'll upload the object. So now, as it's uploading the object, it's storing that checksum along with the object data, and it's also validating the object and checksumming that on our server, and it will only store that data if those checksums match. Great. So that uploaded successfully. The next object I'm going to upload. But this time, I'm not going to specify a pre-calculated value. Instead, I'll let the AWS console upload that checksum or calculate that checksum while it's uploading it. So I'll go to properties again, and I'll turn on additional checksums, and I'll select a SHA-256 checksum here, and I'll leave this pre-calculated value blank, and I'll upload the object. Okay, so now the console's computing the checksum as it's uploading the data, and that checksum will be stored with the object during its entire lifespan in S3. So if I take a look at this object in the console, and I scroll down, I can see that there's a new box here called Additional Checksums, and I can see that this checksum value was the one that was calculated during the upload. And if I compare that against my catalog, I can see that that's indeed the checksum value that I expected. And so if I go back and I look at that object in the console, I can see that my object was uploaded successfully.